in this video we're going to be showing you how to paint a Khorne Berserker in under 10 paints, so they'll be ready to crush skulls on the battlefield in no time at all. The first thing we need to do is undercoat the model, and for this we've used MEPHISTON Red. This will speed up the process as it will also serve for our base coat for the armour. It's also a good idea to have the base paint that matches the spray to hand. This will help tidy up any mistakes. The paints you need are on the screen right now. Remember that these are our recommendations. Feel free to paint your miniatures however you like. If you are new to painting or want to know the types of paint and the techniques used in this video, check out our Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos in the description. First, we'll apply Berzerker Bloodshade over the red armour. We're shading the armour first to avoid getting any of the shade on the other colours, so doing the messiest stage first is the best way forward. We'll add it in small amounts with our Citadel Small Base Brush, and we'll move it around so it can get in all of those recesses evenly. Berzerker Bloodshade is a great shade for this armour, as it has a punchy red tone with some subtle shadows that goes well over that MEPHISTON red. Now that the shade is dry, we can apply our RUNELORD brass to the trim and iconography. As you're going around applying your first layer, by the time that you've finished your first coat fully on those details, the area that you started on should be dry and you can add another layer. We do this just to build up a solid metallic colour. If we get any of the paint on our red armour, this is easily fixed by using MEPHISTON Red base paint out of the pot, then applying Berzerker Bloodshade over it so all of the armour matches again. Next, we'll use iron-hand steel for our silver metallic areas, such as the weapons, the chains, the pipes, and the backpack details. As we are working near the red armour and brass, we are going to take our time when applying it so we don't make any smudges or get any on those details we've just painted. Don't worry if you do though, we all make mistakes and it's a super easy fix too. Just follow the same steps as we did earlier. Just make sure that the area is fully dry before covering it, as we don't want any metallic flakes to mix into our previous colours. Now we'll apply RAKARTH flesh to any straps, skin, skulls, and weapon handles. We'll try and avoid any of the areas that we've already painted, as this is a lighter colour and will show brightly if we get it on any of those darker colours. We'll take our time and use a Citadel small layer brush to help us with this. Mistakes do happen and this is totally fine. We can tidy this up by using the colours we previously used. After that is dry, we'll use AGRAX Earthshade over the RUNELORD brass and RAKARTH flesh details. We'll try to avoid pooling by applying small amounts and moving it around. You can also thin it with a drop of water for the RAKARTH flesh so it's not too strong and dark when it dries. Shades are designed to run into the recesses of our models and keep the raised areas unshaded, giving an illusion of depth. AGRAX Earthshade is a great colour for the warmer tones on this model without being too dark. Now we're applying Corvus Black to the weapon casings, undersuit and suit piping. We have a lot of colours on our model, so we're going to take our time so we can avoid any smudging on that hard work we've already done. Corvus Black is great for all of these details as it has a slightly grey tone to it. This also gives the piping and the suit a weathered look. With those colours down, we can apply Rattling Grime to the silver and black details. We'll also pop a small amount into the eye sockets to darken them down a touch. Rattling Grime is great for a dark, dirty looking metal, but we don't want to overload the silver too much, so we'll add a small amount of water before applying it. We can always add more Rattling Grime to the recesses or damaged areas after. Next, we'll use Wild Rider Red to pick out the raised areas of the armour. We'll do this by highlighting with our Citadel Small Layer Brush. We'll use the side of the brush to get those sharper edge highlights. Try to keep the lines as thin as possible. We can also add some small cuts to give a worn effect to the armour. This can also make it look battle damaged. Remember, you don't have to highlight every edge. Just highlight those larger and more open edges on the boots, the chest plate and the shoulder pads. But do as much as you want on your models. Finally, we'll apply a small amount of Warpstone Glow into those eye sockets using our Citadel Small Layer Brush. This is to pick out some really easy detail that can give our model a finishing touch. Use the tip of the brush with a small amount of paint on it. We can add a few small thin layers of Warpstone Glow to build up the coverage. And there we are! Your Khorne Berzerker is finished and looks fantastic! You can see that our model is based in Astrogranite, but you can base yours in any colour you want. If you'd like to learn more about basing, check out our technicals video all about it. Well, we hope you enjoyed this video and we'll see you next time. Bye bye!